Well, welcome everybody to the house of the Lord, and we're going to celebrate, right? We're just so happy that we're here in the house of the Lord. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Next song that we're going to sing is a hymn called It Is Well. It's a song that we haven't done in the English service. It's a song that, a hymn that we sang as I was growing up in my Spanish service, Alcancé Salvación. But it's written by a guy named Horatio Spafford. His story is a super interesting one. In fact, me and Jolene were talking last week about praising God in the midst of storm. This guy wrote this hymn, but he wrote it after certain things happened. First of all, he lost his son, all right? He lost most of his wealth in the Chicago fire. This is a man who had a lot of investments in real estate, but he was also someone who believed in God, who did missions and things like that. After losing most of his wealth, his family is traveling over to England for a mission that they're going to do. He was actually going to do this with D.L. Moody. D.L. Moody, that's a very big, you know, institute and all that. On that ship, while they're traveling from here to England, he lost all four of his daughters. His wife survived. He receives a telegram that just says, "Survived alone." This man, after hearing all this, he has to go back to where he is, you know, with his family. So he gets on a boat, and as he's going over the part of the ocean where his family perished and died, he wrote this. When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll. Literally, he's writing hymns about what happened, that sea, the way it billowed and rolled over his family. Whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul. How can a man who lost so much say that? But that right there is the heart of worship. That even though we lose everything on this side of heaven, we know and we recognize that that cross wasn't a mistake. That cross is where our hope is. This man, after losing four daughters, all his money, one son, and his wife that was spared, he still was able to write, to pen one of the most beautiful pieces of music that's ever been written. So let's just think about that as we sing this beautiful hymn together. Amen. Heavenly Father, what a blessing we have that even though we may face trials and tribulations on earth, Father, we shouldn't fear, for you have overcome it. When sin was defeated on the cross by the blood of the Lamb, when death was defeated by his resurrection, Father, in that we find and have hope. May we never lose sight. And may we always remember that no matter what we're going through, it is well in our souls because of what you did, not what we did. In Jesus' name we ask all this. Amen. You may be seated. So as far as announcements, I think we're back to a regular week of services, which means Tuesday nights, the Den, they get together over here in the back. Young adults, high school graduates, college students, 7 p.m. every Tuesday over here in the church, right? And then on Wednesday nights, we have our Bible studies that takes place at 7:30 p.m. here in the temple. We have translations available for those who don't speak Spanish because that is in Spanish, okay? Then we have Los Robles. Is that still canceled for the time being? Los Robles? All right. Moving from Los Robles to Friday Night Youth Group. We have our Friday Night Youth Group, Fearless Youth, that does take place every 7:30 p.m. here at the church. Their devotional starts at 7:30. Before that, they're here having a good time and just fraternizing. You're more than welcome to join them. Even if you don't participate in any of these ministries, there's power in prayer. And just pray for what God's accomplishing through each and every one of these ministries here at this church and in churches outside, because we're not the only ones who are gathering today on a Sunday morning in his name, right? So that's the announcements. Oh, Spanish service on Sundays, 10 a.m. Our Bible study in English. Sunday school takes place in the cafeteria, 10:45. And, of course, we have our English service that starts at 11:45. Today we started a little later at 12 because, we just ran a little longer. There's our Zelle number for anyone who would like to give their tithe or offering in an electronic digital way, 786-409-2645, 786-409-2645. And, of course, we have our offering plates here in the front. At any point during service, when we're singing any song, you're more than welcome to come and leave an offering if you'd like to do so. If not, you could wait until the end of the service. And today we are going to be celebrating communion, so that is a special announcement. It's always exciting when we're able to do that. Outside of that, those are all the announcements. Any questions, feel free to seek us after church or look us up online on Google, Facebook, all that, and you'll see all those schedules on there. Now we're going to stand up in reverence to the Word of God. I'm going to ask my brother Jeremy to lead us in today's scripture.
All right, our reading of the Word is found in Matthew chapter 6, verses 5 through 13. We'll be reading alternating, and I'll start. Verse 5 says, "And when you pray, you shall not be like the hypocrites, for they love to pray standing in the synagogues and on the corners of the streets, that they may be seen by men. Assuredly, I say to you, they have their reward.
But you, when you pray, go into your room, and when you have shut your door, pray to your Father who is in the secret place. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you openly.
And when you pray, do not use vain repetitions as the heathen do, for they think that they will be heard for their many words.
Therefore, do not be like them, for your Father knows the things you have need of before you ask him.
In this manner, therefore, pray, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name.
Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread.
And forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors.
Last verse together.
And do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Let's pray. Dear God, I want to thank you, Father, because you are a good God, and Father, you're deserving of our praise. You're deserving of all the glory, God. God, we want to thank you for this day you've given us to just remember who you are and, God, the gospel that you have given to us, Father, through your Son, Jesus. God, we thank you for it. God, we thank you that you showed mercy on us. When we were sinners, God, and we were in no way of deserving of it, God. God, we pray for the rest of this service that it may be a perfume that is, it's a good perfume, Father, to you. And I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Awesome. And how many reasons do we have to bless the Lord, huh? 1, 2, 100, 10,000? Let's sing.
Father, thank you so much for this day, Lord. God, we worship you, Lord. I'm so thankful for being here today, Lord. As Jonathan was sharing today, Lord, that story, Lord, of circumstances failing on this person's life, Lord, he worshiped you, Lord, and he said it was well with my soul, Lord. God, I don't know what anybody's facing tonight or today, Lord, so I pray that as we leave this place, we live here full of you, Lord, full of your presence, of your love, of your mercy, of your grace, that we don't live empty here and that we're able to live life to the fullest out there, Lord, for you and for your glory. God, I pray for everything you have done for us and you keep doing. We're so thankful for everything that you keep blessing the teaching today, that we're able to open our hearts to you and that we're able to learn. God, thank you for everything. I pray all this in the beautiful name of Jesus. Amen.
Morning, church. Welcome to the house of the Lord. This is a wonderful time because we're going to approach the Lord's Supper. The Bible teaches that Christ gave his body up and shed his blood for each and every one of us. And in remembrance to him, we come to this table to memorize him. The words of the Apostle Paul to the church in Corinth. The Apostle Paul writes, "For I received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'Take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me.'" In the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." "For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death till he comes." We're going to invite Jorlen to help us deliver these elements to each and every one of you guys. Thank you. Brothers, this bread represents the body of Christ Jesus.
El cuerpo de Jesús fue quebrantado por nosotros en la cruz.
The body of Christ Jesus was broken on Calvary for us.
Por eso en su nombre y en memoria de él es dado a vosotros.
That's why in his name and in remembrance to him it's given to us.
Comer del todos.
Take, eat.
La copa del nuevo pacto en la sangre de Jesús.
The cup of the new covenant in the blood of Jesus Christ.
La sangre de Jesús fue derramada por cada uno de nosotros en la cruz.
The blood of Jesus was shed on the cross for each and every one of us.
Por eso en su nombre y en memoria de él es dada a vosotros.
That's why in his name and in remembrance to him it's given to us.
Bebed de ella todos.
Drink.
Oramos.
Let's pray.
Señor, te damos gracias por este momento.
Lord, we thank you for this moment.
Gracias por recordar y proclamar la muerte de Cristo.
Thank you for allowing us to remember and proclaim the death of Jesus Christ.
Gracias por tu cuerpo quebrantado.
Thank you for your broken body.
Gracias por tu sangre derramada.
For your blood that was shed.
Porque ahí está nuestra redención.
Because that's where our redemption is.
El perdón de nuestros pecados.
The forgiveness of our sins.
Y la vida eterna, Señor.
And eternal life.
Bendice a tu iglesia.
Bless your church, Father.
Y ayúdanos siempre a recordarlo.
And help us always remember.
Y que este acto pueda inspirar a otros.
And may this act inspire others.
Para que también te puedan conocer y seguirte a ti.
To also know you and follow you.
Lo pedimos en el nombre de Jesús.
We ask this in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Bueno, pues, buenos días una vez más para todos ustedes.
Well, good morning once again to all of you guys.
Qué bueno que ustedes están acá en esta mañana compartiendo.
So good that you guys are here sharing this morning.
Y hoy voy a tratar un tema que yo creo todos conocemos acerca de la oración.
And today I'm going to touch a subject that I think we all know about prayer.
Le he titulado Orando de manera efectiva.
I've titled it Praying Effectively.
Y yo sé que la mayoría piensan que ya esto es un tema un poco gastado.
And I know that most people might think this topic is played out.
Que es un tema muy básico para la iglesia.
That it's very basic for the church.
Que quizás un sermón de la oración está bien para nuevos creyentes.
And perhaps a sermon about prayer is good for new believers.
Y no tanto para mí que llevo tantos años en el evangelio.
And not so much for me that I have so many years in the gospel.
Pero yo no estoy de acuerdo con esa idea.
But I'm not in agreement with that
y yo creo
idea.
Que la evidencia me da la razón.
And I believe evidence gives me the reason.
Si los creyentes, ya sean nuevos creyentes o de muchos años,
so regardless of how long you've been a believer,
conocieran lo suficiente sobre la oración,
if they knew enough about prayer,
entonces, ¿por qué no se ve el poder de la oración en la vida de los creyentes?
Well, then why don't we see the power of prayer in those believers' lives?
¿Por qué no vemos las evidencias de la respuesta de Dios a las oraciones?
Why don't we see the evidences of God answering prayers?
Y yo creo que hay dos factores importantes.
And I think there's two important factors.
Uno es que no se ora lo suficiente.
One is that we don't pray enough.
O sencillamente no se ora.
Or simply we don't pray at all.
Hay personas que le pasa una semana y no oran nunca.
There's some people who go weeks without praying.
En segundo lugar.
Secondly,
Santiago nos dice,
James tells us,
que oramos y oramos mal,
that if we do not pray correctly,
porque pedimos para nuestros deleites,
because we ask to spend it on our pleasures.
Así que la oración es un tema,
so prayer is a topic,
que la iglesia tiene que venir una y otra vez,
that the church needs to revisit
hay
often,
que insistir,
and we need to insist on,
y hay que establecer una buena teología sobre la oración,
and establish a good theology on prayer,
y una buena motivación para orar,
and a proper motivation to prayer.
Miren, cuando una persona se convierte al evangelio,
when a person is converted to the gospel,
casi siempre se le orienta dos cosas.
Almost always they're taught two particular things.
Dos hábitos que debe de incorporar inmediatamente a su vida.
Two important habits that they should incorporate immediately.
La lectura de la palabra de Dios.
Reading of the word of God.
Y la oración.
And prayer.
Y esto es correcto.
And this is
correct. Y es necesario que lo hagamos.
And necessary that we do it.
Pero en la vida práctica,
but in our lives, in our day-to-day,
cuesta mucho que este hábito se haga efectivo en la vida de las personas.
It's hard to see this as an effective habit in most people's lives.
La mayoría de las personas lo que practican es un ritual.
Most people, what they end up practicing is just a ritual.
Ya sea en la lectura o ya sea en la oración.
Whether it's in reading of scripture or in prayer.
Mucha gente dice, no, yo me leí la Biblia en el año, de tapa a tapa.
Many people say, oh, I read the whole Bible in a whole year, in one year.
Y yo tengo la costumbre de orar tres veces al día.
And I have the habit of praying three times a day.
Bueno, cuidado, que si le pones dos veces más se va a convertir en un musulmán que ora cinco veces al día.
Careful, if you add two more to that, you end up being a Muslim. They do that five times a day.
La gran realidad,
the sad truth,
es que siempre debemos estar en contacto con Dios.
Is that we should always be in contact with God.
¿Cuántas veces es correcto orar? Esa pregunta me la han hecho.
What's the right amount of times to pray? I've been asked that.
Constantemente, cada vez que tengas una necesidad, cada vez que tengas que hablar con Dios.
And the answer is constantly. Anytime you have a need, speak with God.
A veces yo voy por el palmetto.
Sometimes I'm on the palmetto.
Y me pasa alguien.
And someone just zooms past me.
Y yo digo, Señor, bendice a ese que va ahí.
And I say, Lord, bless that person.
Y que no se mate él ni mate a nadie.
And may he not perish and not kill anybody else.
Eso es una oración.
That's a prayer.
Y no era planificado.
And it wasn't one that I planned.
Tenemos el derecho de hablar con Dios sobre todas circunstancias de la vida y en todo momento.
We have the right to speak with God at any moment.
Y debemos ejercer estos hábitos con total libertad.
And we should exercise these habits with complete freedom.
Y con total sencillez.
And with complete humbleness.
Pero una cosa es saber intelectualmente el valor de la oración y la lectura de la palabra.
But one thing is to intellectually understand the importance of scripture and prayer.
Y otra cosa es que lo podamos vivir de manera práctica.
And another thing is to actually put it into practice in our lives.
Yo creo que todo el mundo entiende el valor de leer la Biblia y orar.
I think we all understand the value of reading scripture and prayer.
A ver, ¿cuántos de ustedes saben?
Let's see, how many of you guys know
el valor que tiene hacer ejercicio y comer sano?
The value of doing exercise and eating right.
Y en realidad, ¿cuántos comen sano y cuántos hacen ejercicio?
And in reality, how many of you eat right and do exercise?
O sea, lo sabemos aquí en la mente.
So we know it intellectually.
Pero nos cuesta vivirlo en la vida práctica.
But it's hard for us to actually put it into practice, action.
El cristiano sabe que debe de leer la Biblia y orar.
Christians know that we should read the Bible and pray.
Intelectualmente lo sabe.
Intellectually, we understand it.
Pero en la práctica, ¿lo haces?
But in reality, do we actually do it?
Y miren, el pasaje que nos ocupa en esta mañana,
so the passage of scripture that we reviewed,
lo leíamos allí en el Evangelio de Mateo,
in the Gospel of Matthew, we read it,
tiene que ver con el Sermón del Monte.
Takes place in the Sermon of the Mount.
Jesús enseña sobre diferentes temas.
Jesus taught about different topics.
Pero uno de los temas que enseña es la oración.
But one of the ones he discussed was prayer.
Debemos notar que el pasaje paralelo en el Evangelio de Lucas,
and we should note that in the parallel passage in the Gospel of Luke,
nos deja saber que esta enseñanza llegó,
tells us that this particular teaching came because,
como respuesta a la petición de un discípulo.
A particular disciple had asked to teach him.
Miren lo que dice Lucas capítulo 11 versículo 1.
Luke 11 verse 1.
Aconteció que estaba Jesús orando en un lugar y cuando terminó uno de sus discípulos le dijo, Señor, enséñanos a orar como también Juan enseñó a sus discípulos.
Now it came to pass as he was praying in certain place when he sees that one of his disciples said to him, Lord, teach us to pray as John also taught his disciples.
Señor, enséñanos a orar.
Lord, teach us to pray.
Y alguno puede decir, ¿qué petición tan simple, ¿verdad?
Some might say, well, what a simple request.
Pero qué importante.
But such an important one.
Los discípulos no es que nunca habrían orado.
It's not that the disciples had not prayed.
Ellos eran judíos.
They were Jewish.
Iban a la sinagoga.
They would go to the synagogues.
Con seguridad habían orado.
Surely they had prayed.
Pero aquí hay uno diciéndole, enséñanos a orar.
But one of them here is saying, teach us to pray.
Y la Biblia dice que Jesús les enseñó a sus discípulos.
And scripture says that Jesus did teach his disciples.
Y nosotros conocemos esto como la oración modelo.
And we know it as the model prayer.
Ahora, a veces se nos olvida que es un modelo.
Times we forget that it's just a model.
Muchas personas las han aprendido de memoria.
Some people have just engraved it in memory.
Y recitan el famoso Padre Nuestro.
And they recite the famous Heavenly Father, Hallowed be thy name.
Como si fueran palabras mágicas.
As if they were magical words.
Hay quien piensa que por orar el Padre Nuestro algo bueno va a suceder en su vida.
There are those who think because they pray that particular prayer that something good is going to take place in their lives.
Con seguridad usted ha visto eso.
Surely you've seen that.
Padre Nuestro que estás en los cielos.
Heavenly Father,
santificado sea tu nombre.
Hallowed be thy name.
Y después cuando terminamos.
And when we finish.
Y pensamos que algo bueno va a suceder por eso.
And we're assuming something's good is going to happen because of what we did.
Pero yo les invito a que podamos revisar algunas instrucciones más que da Jesús sobre la oración.
But I invite you to see some other instructions, additional instructions that Jesus gives with respect to this.
Vamos a regresar allí a Mateo.
Let's go back to the Gospel of Matthew.
Versículo 5.
Chapter 6, verse 5.
Y cuando ores no seas como los hipócritas porque ellos aman el orar en pie en las sinagogas y en las esquinas de las calles para ser visto de los hombres. De cierto os digo que ya tienen su recompensa.
And when you pray, you shall not be like the hypocrites, for they love to pray standing in the synagogues and on the corners of the streets, that they may be seen by men. Assuredly, I say to you, they have their reward.
Verso 6. Mas tú cuando ores, entra en tu aposento y cerrada la puerta, ora a tu padre que está en secreto, y tu padre que ve en lo secreto te recompensará en público.
But you, when you pray, go into your room, and when you have shut your door, pray to your father who is in the secret place, and your father who sees in secret will reward you openly.
Y orando, no uséis vanas repeticiones como los gentiles que piensan que por su palabrería serán oídos.
And when you pray, do not use vain repetitions as the heathens do.
Verso 8. No os hagáis pues semejante a ellos porque vuestro Padre sabe de qué cosa tenéis necesidad antes que vosotros le pidáis.
Therefore do not be like them, for your Father knows the things you have need of before you ask him.
Así que lo primero que nos está enseñando Jesús sobre la oración.
So the first thing Jesus is teaching about prayer.
Es que no seas un hipócrita.
Is to not be a hypocrite.
Así que Jesús está dando por sentado.
Jesus is giving as a guarantee, essentially.
Que en la oración no puede haber ningún tipo de actuación.
That in prayer, it can't be an act.
¿Saben quién era un hipócrita?
Do you know what a hypocrite was back then?
Viene de la palabra del griego.
Comes from the Greek word.
Y es un artista.
And it's basically an actor.
Alguien que representa un papel.
Someone who was acting a part.
Por eso cuando conocemos a alguien que dice una cosa y hace otra,
that's why when we say someone who says something but does something else,
decimos esta persona es un hipócrita.
We say this person is a hypocrite.
Está actuando.
They're acting.
Y Jesús está diciendo, cuando tú ores,
and Jesus is saying, when you pray,
no vengas a representar un papel.
You're not going to act about something.
Este calificativo de hipócrita Jesús lo usaba ¿con quién?
This word for hypocrite, he would use it with who, against who?
Lo usaba con los religiosos de su época.
Well, against the religious people of his time.
Lo usaba con los fariseos, los escribas, los intérpretes de la ley.
The Pharisees, the scribes, the interpreters of the law.
Jesús le decía, ustedes son hipócritas.
Jesus would tell them that you guys are hypocrites.
Porque dicen una cosa y hacen otra.
You say one thing, but you do another.
Ahora, Jesús dice en este texto,
in this text, Jesus says,
no seas como un hipócrita que ama orar en la sinagoga,
to not be like a hypocrite who loves to pray standing in the synagogues,
o en las esquinas de las plazas,
and in the corners of the streets,
solo con el único objetivo de qué?
With their objective being what?
De ser visto por los hombres.
To be seen by men.
Ubíquese en Jerusalén.
So, imagine yourself in Jerusalem.
Y que usted está pasando por una plaza.
And you're going through a plaza.
Y en una esquina.
And in a corner.
Hay alguien allí con las manos alzadas.
There's a guy with his hands raised.
Y hablando altísimo, orando altísimo.
Speaking super loud.
Imposible pasar por allí y no mirarlo.
And potentially you pass by and you don't even look at him.
Pues eso es lo que quería esa persona.
Well, that's exactly what that person wanted.
Y Jesús dice, eso es lo que tú quieres, que te vean.
Jesus is saying, that's what you want to be
ya
seen.
Ya te vimos, muchas gracias.
Surely I say to you.
Gracias, ya te vi.
They have the reward. Thanks, but no thanks.
Ahora dice Jesús, ¿qué quieres despertar sobre tu persona?
So, Jesus is saying, what, you want to get something out of your own person?
Una opinión de que eres un hombre espiritual.
A favorable opinion that you're a spiritual man.
Imagínese que usted entre por aquí.
Imagine you come in through here.
Y lo primero que usted se encuentra es un hermano ahí tirado de rodillas orando.
The first thing you find is a brother on his knees praying.
Y uno pasa y dice, bueno, me voy a mi silla.
And one passes, I'm going to go to my chair.
Pero este hermano sí que es espiritual.
But this man is spiritual.
Yo no, yo nunca he hecho eso.
I've never done it.
Y a veces uno se siente mal.
And perhaps I might feel bad.
Bueno, si tú quieres tirarte de rodillas ahí para que todo el mundo te vea.
Well, if you want to get on your knees so that other people could see you.
Ya te vimos.
We've seen you.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you.
Jesús dice, no seas un hipócrita, no actúes.
Jesus says, don't be a hypocrite, don't be acting.
Y yo no estoy diciendo que está mal arrodillarse aquí en el templo y orar.
And I'm not saying that it's bad to get on your knees and praying in the temple.
Pero cuidado con las motivaciones de tu corazón.
But careful with the motivations of your heart.
Porque Jesús da una instrucción muy clara.
Because Jesus gives one clear instruction.
En el siguiente verso Jesús dice.
In verse 6 he says.
Cuando tú ores.
But when you pray.
Tienes que hacer algo.
You gotta do one thing.
Entra en tu aposento.
Go into your room.
Y además dice, cierra la puerta.
And on top of that, and when you have shut your door.
Porque a lo mejor yo puedo entrar y dejar la puerta abierta para que el que pase me esté mirando.
Maybe I go to my room, but I leave the door wide open so that, you know, people could still see me.
Jesús está invitando a que cuando oremos, entremos con el Señor en una intimidad.
Jesus is telling us to form a level of intimacy.
En una privacidad.
In privacy.
Dice, entra en tu aposento, cierra la puerta.
Says, go to your room, shut your door.
Y tu Padre que ve en lo secreto.
And pray to your Father who is in the secret place.
Te recompensará en público.
Who sees in secret will reward you openly.
Y esa es la sugerencia del Señor.
And that's the Lord's suggestion.
Privacidad con Dios.
Privacy, intimacy with God.
Y uno diría, okay, ya entendí.
And one might say, okay, I got it.
No voy a estar haciendo una actuación en público.
I'm not going to be acting out, pretending in public.
Me voy a trancar en mi habitación.
I'm going to, you know, lock the door in my room.
Y voy a orar a Dios.
I'm going to pray to God.
Pero Jesús enseña algunas cosas más.
But Jesus goes beyond that.
Okay, ya estás en tu cuarto con el Señor.
Okay, you're in your room with the Lord.
Pero mire lo que dice la próxima enseñanza.
But look at what he teaches in the next verse.
Y orando.
And when you pray,
no uses vanas repeticiones.
Do not use vain repetitions.
Como los gentiles,
as the heathens do.
Que piensan que por su palabrería serán oídos.
For they think that they will be heard for their many words.
Ahora, Jesús no está diciendo que yo no puedo repetir una oración.
Jesus isn't saying that I can't use a repetition.
De hecho, en otra parábola,
in fact, in another parable,
Jesús habló o enseñó de la necesidad de orar siempre.
Jesus spoke about the need to pray without ceasing.
Y de insistirle a Dios, a veces en algún tema.
To insist with God.
¿Recuerda la parábola de la viuda con el juez injusto?
Like the parable of the widow with the unjust judge.
Esa mujer le decía, hazme justicia de mi adversario.
That woman kept on saying, give me justice against my adversary.
Y volví al otro día, hazme justicia de mi adversario.
The following day, same deal, give me justice against my adversary.
Así que Jesús no se está refiriendo a ese tipo de repetición.
So Jesus isn't referring to that type of repetition.
Sino a la repetición que es vana.
Rather, a vain repetition.
A la palabrería que es vana.
It's just having like fancy words that are just hollow.
¿No ha escuchado usted a alguien a veces orar?
Ever heard someone perhaps pray?
Y usa algunas palabras.
And they use certain words.
Que uno diría, sería bueno tener un diccionario al lado para entender lo que está diciendo este hermano.
Where you're like, man, I need a dictionary just to understand what he's praying.
Porque no lo entiendo.
Because I don't get him.
Porque se usó esa palabrita que se aprendió rara por ahí.
Because he used that fancy word he just learned.
Y dice, voy a dejar a todo el mundo aquí perdido.
And he says, I'm gonna show off here.
¿Eh? Vas a tener que buscar en el diccionario porque yo soy una gente muy culta.
They're going to have to Google it because I'm such a smart guy.
Jesús dice, no uses vana palabrería como los gentiles.
Jesus says, don't use vain repetitions as the heathens do.
La gente le encanta adornar la oración.
People love to put decorations on prayer.
¿Se ha fijado usted en un arbolito de Navidad?
Have you ever noticed a Christmas tree?
Hay gente que quieren ponerle tantas cositas al arbolito de Navidad.
There's people who want to put so many things on that tree.
Pero tantas que se ve horrible.
But so many that it's just overloaded. It looks terrible.
Yo a veces he visto un árbol de Navidad tan sencillo.
I've seen some simple trees before.
Y uno dice, oye, qué lindo te quedó.
And it looks beautiful.
Porque está sencillo.
Because it's simple.
Lo sencillo funciona.
What simple works.
¿No ha escuchado usted a alguien orar?
Have you heard someone pray?
Y cuando termina de orar,
that when they finish praying,
usted se queda pensando y dice,
you stay with yourself thinking,
¿y este por qué oró?
What did he pray about?
Porque dijo tantas cosas, pero al final no entendí por qué estaba orando.
He said so many things, but I got lost, and I don't know what he prayed about.
Porque a veces damos vueltas en la oración, y vueltas y más vueltas.
Because sometimes all we do is go round and round.
Y yo pienso que a veces Dios está así con...
And I figure God at times might just be covering his ears
to that.
Please stop.
No uses vana palabrería.
Don't use vain repetitions.
Pero hay otra cosa más que nos enseña Jesús referente a la oración.
But there's another thing that Jesus teaches with respect to prayer.
Y yo creo que esto es tan importante.
And I think it's so important.
Este pensamiento a mí me sacude.
This thought is one that just shakes me to my core.
Cuando usted ora,
when you pray,
cuando usted va a pedirle a Dios algo,
when you're going to ask of God anything,
¿sabe usted que ya Dios sabe de lo que usted tiene necesidad?
Do you know that God already knows what you're going to ask or need?
Y quiero que lo medite.
And just meditate on that.
Miren lo que dice ese versículo 7.
Look what verse 8 says, 8.
Si me lo pones, 8, 8, I'm sorry.
Verse 8.
Dice, no os hagáis pues semejante a ellos, porque vuestro Padre sabe de qué cosa tenéis necesidad antes de que vosotros se la pidáis.
Therefore, do not be like them, for your Father knows the things you have need of before you ask him.
Jesús nos está recordando que estamos orando a un Dios.
Jesus is reminding us that we're praying to a God
que es omnisciente,
who's omniscient,
que es omnisapiente,
omnisapient,
que sabe todo,
who knows all,
y no se está enterando porque yo estoy abriendo mis labios para hablar con él.
And he's not finding it out because I spoke this.
Ahora, Dios sabe de qué tengo necesidad.
Now he knows the things I have need of.
Dios no está para cumplir mis antojos.
He's not there to fulfill my wants.
Por eso Santiago dice que pedimos y pedimos mal.
That's why James wrote that we ask, but we ask wrong.
Porque pedimos para nuestros propios deseos.
Because we ask based on our pleasures.
Así que antes de que Jesús diga lo que conocemos como la oración modelo,
so before Jesus even went into the model prayer,
Jesús enseña cuatro cosas.
He teaches four principles.
No actúes en la oración.
Don't act, don't pretend in prayer.
Busca un lugar privado para orar a Dios.
Seek a private place to pray to God.
No uses vana palabrería.
Don't use vain repetitions, a bunch of fancy words.
Y ten en mente que antes de hablar conmigo, ya yo sé lo que tú
and
necesitas.
Keep in mind, before we speak, I already know what you need.
Wow, eso es bien revelador.
That reveals a lot.
Así que, después de hacer estas observaciones,
so after noticing these observations,
Jesús comienza a dar un modelo de oración.
Jesus then enters into the model prayer.
Y quiero tocar algunos de estos puntos.
And I want to touch a few of these points.
Y lo vamos a hacer de manera breve.
And we're going to go over this briefly.
Pero en esta oración modelo,
but in this model prayer,
Jesús comienza diciendo, Padre nuestro que estás en los cielos.
He starts it off by saying, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name.
¿A quién le ora usted?
Who are we praying to?
Pues le oramos al Padre.
Well, to our Father, the Father.
Porque la Biblia siempre nos enseña que nuestra oración es dirigida al Padre.
Because the Bible teaches us that our prayer is directed to the Father.
El famoso teléfono de Dios.
The famous telephone of God.
Jeremías 33:3.
Jeremiah 33:3.
Clama a mí y yo te responderé.
Exclaim to me and I will respond.
Dios dice, clama a mí.
Exclaim to me. God
clamamos says. Al Padre.
We're talking, we're sending our needs to God the Father.
Es Padre nuestro.
He's our Father.
Nuestro por adopción.
Ours through adoption.
Pablo dice que hemos recibido el espíritu de adopción.
Paul writes that we have got the spirit of adoption.
Por el cual ahora nosotros podemos clamar.
By whom we cry out.
Abba, Padre.
Abba, Father.
¿Qué quiere decir padrecito o papacito?
Which is a very tender way of basically saying like dad or daddy.
Daddy, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Y nos recuerda nuestra posición delante de Dios.
And it reminds us of our position in relationship to God.
Padre nuestro, pero ¿estás dónde?
Our Father, who's where though?
En el cielo.
In heaven.
Y yo soy un pobre mortal en la tierra.
And I'm just a simple mortal here on earth.
Hay una diferencia entre el creador y el ser creado.
Big difference between the creator and the created.
El ser creado clama a su creador.
The created exclaims to that creator.
No le da órdenes.
Doesn't direct that creator.
Y la oración a veces la usamos para darle órdenes a Dios.
And many times we pray just to instruct God.
Recuerda, Él es el Padre, está en el cielo.
Remember, He's our Father who is in heaven.
Y nosotros somos una cosita así en la tierra, ¿verdad?
And we're just little ants here.
Lo segundo que dice esta oración es, santificado sea tu nombre.
The second thing he follows that up with is, hallowed be your name.
Y algunas personas piensan que cuando decimos eso,
some people think that when we say that,
estamos haciendo a Dios santo.
We're making God hallowed, sent, holy.
Pero no olvide,
but do not forget,
que Dios es santo antes de la creación del mundo.
God is holy before the creation of the world.
Él es Dios eterno.
He's the eternal God.
Siempre ha sido santo.
He's always been holy.
Siempre será santo.
He always will be holy.
Tres veces santo.
Three times holy.
Así que cuando usted dice, santificado sea tu nombre,
so when you say, hallowed be your name,
no es que usted está santificando a Dios, Él lo es.
It's not that you're hallowing Him or making Him holy. He already
lo ha
is.
Sido siempre.
He always has been.
Se trata de santificar a Dios en tu vida.
Rather, it's sanctifying God in our own lives.
Primera de Pedro, capítulo 3, versículo 15.
1 Peter 3, 15.
Miren cómo comienza este texto.
Look at how this starts, this verse.
Pedro dice, si no santificar a Dios el Señor en vuestros corazones.
But sanctify the Lord God in your hearts.
Así que estamos hablando de verdaderamente consagrarme a Dios.
We're talking about consecrating the Lord.
Santificar a Dios en mi vida.
Sanctifying God in our lives.
Porque hay un llamamiento de Dios sobre mi vida.
Because there's a calling of God in my life.
Dios dijo.
God said.
Sed santos porque yo soy santo.
Be holy, for I am holy.
Levítico capítulo 11, versículo 44.
Leviticus 11:44.
Allí lo dice, ¿verdad? Ser santo porque soy santo.
You shall be holy, for I am holy.
Dice esta oración, venga tu reino.
This prayer then follows that with your kingdom come.
Y es muy consecuente esta petición con las enseñanzas de Jesús.
And this particular petition goes with what Jesus has been teaching all along.
Jesús decía, el reino de los cielos se ha acercado.
Jesus was teaching that the kingdom of heaven was coming.
El reino de los cielos ciertamente está entre vosotros.
The kingdom of heaven certainly is among you.
El evangelio del reino es predicado.
The gospel of the kingdom is preached.
Pero la idea de un reino tiene un mensaje muy claro.
But the idea of a kingdom has a clear message.
Donde hay un reino,
if there's a kingdom,
hay un rey.
There's a king.
Que gobierna y todo está bajo su control.
Who governs everything and everything is under their control.
Venga tu reino.
Your kingdom come.
El creyente debe anhelar vivir.
Believers should be seeking this.
Como un ciudadano del reino.
To live as citizens of his kingdom.
Y bajo la autoridad del rey.
And under the authority of that kingdom's king.
Y lo que sigue en esta oración.
And what he follows that with.
Corrobora este pensamiento.
Corroborates that train of thought.
Porque sigue esta oración diciendo, hágase tu voluntad.
And then he follows it with, your will be done.
Como en el cielo, así también en la tierra.
On earth as it is in heaven.
El creyente desea la voluntad del rey.
The believer desires that will of that king.
Porque la voluntad del rey es agradable y perfecta.
Because the will of that king is pleasing and perfect.
Lo dice Pablo en Romanos capítulo 12 y versículo 2.
Paul writes that in Romans 12 verses 1 and 2.
Que debemos ser transformados en nuestra mente.
That we should be transformed in our minds.
El creyente es renovado.
By the renewing of our minds.
En el entendimiento.
In our understanding.
Y comprueba que la voluntad de Dios es buena, agradable y perfecta.
To prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
Ahora, miren específicamente lo que dice esta oración.
But look at what specifically this prayer says.
Hágase tu voluntad.
Your will be done.
Como en el cielo.
On earth.
Así también en la tierra.
As it is in heaven.
¿Qué ustedes creen que pasa en los cielos?
What do you think happens in heaven?
Ese ejército de los cielos.
Those heavenly hosts.
¿Se ha podido usted se imagina esta escena de Dios en su gloria?
Have you imagined this scene of Jesus, God in his glory?
Rodeado de todo ese ejército de los cielos que la Biblia nos habla.
Surrounded by the heavenly host that's mentioned in scripture.
¿Qué voluntad usted cree que se hace en el cielo?
What will do you think takes place up there?
Se hace la voluntad de Dios.
Or the will of God.
Todos esos seres viven bajo la voluntad de Dios.
All those beings live under his will.
Y esta oración es ese clamor.
And this prayer is that exclamation.
Hágase tu voluntad.
Your will be done.
Como se hace en el cielo.
On earth.
Que fuera aquí en la tierra.
As it is in heaven.
Porque el creyente debe anhelar hacer la voluntad del Padre.
Because the believer should want to do the will of the Father.
Pero antes de conocer al Padre.
But before knowing the Father.
¿Bajo qué voluntad vivíamos?
Under what will were we living?
Pablo le escribe sobre este tema a los Efesios.
Paul speaks specifically about this in Ephesians.
Capítulo 2, versículos 2 y 3.
Chapter 2, verses 2 and 3.
Pablo hablando de la antigua condición antes de conocer a Cristo.
Talking about our former condition before knowing Christ.
Les dice, en los cuales anduviste en otro tiempo siguiendo la corriente de este mundo conforme al príncipe de la potestad del aire, el espíritu que ahora opera en los hijos de desobediencia.
In which you once walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit who now works in the sons of disobedience.
Entre los cuales también todos nosotros vivimos en otro tiempo en los deseos de nuestra carne y haciendo la voluntad de la carne y de los pensamientos, y éramos por naturaleza hijos de ira, lo mismo que los demás.
Among whom also we all once conducted ourselves in the lusts of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature children of wrath, just as the others.
Sin Cristo vivíamos bajo la voluntad de la carne y los pensamientos.
Without Christ, we're basically under the will of our flesh and our lusts.
Bajo la influencia de Satanás, como él gobierna en este mundo.
Under Satan's influence, he's the one running it here.
Pero ahora somos cristianos.
But now we're Christians.
Y debemos anhelar hacer la voluntad del Padre.
And we should desire to do the will of the Father.
Por eso hágase, Señor, tu voluntad como en el cielo, aquí también en la tierra.
That's why, Lord, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Esta oración continúa.
This prayer continues.
Y dice Jesús, y el pan nuestro de cada día, dánoslo hoy.
Jesus continues, give us this day our daily bread.
Así que aquí no hay duda de que estamos hablando de una provisión para nuestras vidas.
Here it's clear that it's nothing less than provision for our lives.
El pan,
bread,
es el símbolo más universal de sustento.
Is the most universal symbol for food.
¿Habrá alguna cultura sobre la tierra que no coma pan?
Is there any culture on earth that does not eat bread?
Todo el mundo conoce el pan.
Everyone knows bread.
Ahora bien, la expresión el pan nuestro de cada día.
But this phrase, give us this day our daily bread.
Es una declaración de que Dios es nuestro proveedor.
Is also a declaration that God is our provider.
Pero yo quiero que usted note.
But I want you to note
que dice cada día.
That he mentions daily.
Y después dice, dánoslos hoy.
He says, give us this.
Así
day.
Que Dios otorga pan cada día.
In other words, God gives bread every day.
Y hoy tengo que decirle, dame el que me toca hoy.
And I need to tell God today, give me the bread that I'm due today, please.
Y aquí hay una lección importantísima.
And there's a super important lesson here.
Y es la dependencia diaria de Dios.
And it's daily dependence to God.
Yo no le puedo decir a Dios.
I can't tell God.
Y el pan de la semana entera, dámelo hoy.
Give me the whole week's worth of bread today.
O el pan del mes entero, dámelo hoy.
Or the whole month, give it to me today, please.
Jesús enseña una dependencia diaria.
Jesus is teaching here a daily dependence on him.
Cuando Dios dispensó el maná del cielo,
when God gave manna from heaven to his people,
¿con qué frecuencia Dios lo daba?
With what frequency would he give manna to his people?
Cuando el pueblo de Israel estaba allí en el desierto,
when the people of Israel were in the wilderness,
no había un Publix para ir a comprar el pan.
There was no supermarket to go buy bread.
Solo Dios podía alimentarlos.
Only God
could dependían de Dios.
They needed to depend on God.
Y Dios comenzó a darle pan del cielo.
And God gave them bread from the heavens.
¿Con qué frecuencia se lo daba?
And with what frequency did he give them food?
Diario.
Daily.
Y si alguien quería pasarse de inteligente,
and if anybody wanted to be slick,
y cogía una doble porción,
and get, you know, double portion for today and tomorrow,
esa porción se dañaba.
That extra portion would go bad.
No servía.
It was worthless.
Tenías que confiar que al otro día Dios te iba a dar.
They needed to trust that the following day God was going to provide again.
Y solo en preparación para el día de reposo,
and only in preparation for the day of rest, the
podían
Sabbath,
recoger una doble porción.
Could they get a double portion?
Pero nunca les faltó el maná.
But never were they lacking.
Dependencia diaria de Dios.
It was a daily dependence on God.
El pan nuestro de cada día.
Our daily
hoy.
Bread. Give us this day, please.
Sigue esta oración y dice, y perdona nuestras deudas.
And he follows us, and forgive us our debts.
Como también perdonamos a nuestros deudores.
As we forgive our debtors.
Y esta petición,
and this petition here,
es una, yo diría una obvia alusión,
I think is an obvious allusion,
a la responsabilidad de estar a cuentas con Dios.
To our responsibility to be accountable and squared with God.
Así como dependemos diario del sustento de Dios,
in the same way that we depend daily on God's sustaining us with food,
diariamente debemos estar a cuentas con el Padre.
Well, daily we should be squared in our accounts with God.
Miren, miren esta petición.
Look at this petition.
Perdona nuestras deudas.
And forgive us our debts.
¿Se acostó usted anoche con deudas?
Did you go to sleep last night with any debt?
Y no estoy hablando de deudas de dinero.
We're not talking financial.
¿Se acostó usted anoche en paz con Dios?
But did you go to bed in peace with God?
¿Saben? Hay un salmo que le enseñan a los niños.
There's a psalm that's taught to the children.
En paz me acostaré y así mismo dormiré.
That in peace I shall lay myself to sleep.
Porque solo tú, Jehová, me haces vivir confiado.
Because only in you, Lord, can I live trusting.
En paz me acostaré.
In peace, I shall go to sleep.
Y así mismo dormiré.
And like that, I shall rest.
¿Cuántos pudieron dormir bien anoche?
How many of us got a good night's rest last night?
¿Saben ustedes que todos los días aumenta el consumo de medicamentos para poder dormir?
Did you know that every day there's more and more people who are depending on medications to sleep?
Hay mucha gente que, aunque se compran el mejor colchón,
there's many people who buy the best mattress,
ortopédicos, esos que dan
orthopedic,
masaje,
massage,
y con todo eso se acuestan,
and even with all that,
y no pueden dormir.
They're still restless at night.
Porque nada más que ponen la cabeza en la almohada,
because once they lay their head on the pillow,
y empiezan a llegar todos los problemas y todas las cosas que están pendientes,
all the problems just start swirling in their heads.
Dice el salmista, en paz me acostaré.
The psalmist writes that in peace I shall lay myself to rest.
Y el resultado de acostarme en paz,
the result of laying myself to rest,
es dormir bien.
Is to sleep well.
Y así mismo dormiré.
And in that same manner I shall sleep.
Es el resultado de acostarme en paz.
It's the result of laying myself to rest in peace.
Pero para acostarme en paz tengo que estar en paz con Dios.
But to lay myself to rest in peace, I have to be squared with God.
La Biblia enseña a estar a cuentas con Dios.
Scripture teaches us to be squared up with him.
Y en esta oración Jesús nos enseña eso.
And in this prayer, Jesus is teaching us.
Perdona nuestras deudas.
Forgive us our debts.
Significa hablar con Dios en oración.
Means to speak to God in prayer.
Y darle tratamiento a todas esas situaciones de la vida.
And to directly address all of those situations in our lives.
Que vienen a robar mi paz.
That are stealing, robbing me of my peace.
Pero no solo se trata de estar bien con Dios.
It's not just about me being in peace with God.
Sino de estar bien con el prójimo.
But also with my neighbor.
Perdona mis deudas como también perdono a mis deudores.
And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors.
Porque de qué te vale estar bien con Dios?
Because what good is it for me to be good with God?
O creer que estás bien con Dios.
Or better said, think that I'm good with God.
Si estás peleado con tu hermano.
If I'm fighting with my brother.
Si estás fajado con fulano o con mengano.
If I'm not well with this person or that one.
Perdona mis deudas. Como perdono a mis deudores.
Forgive us my debts.
La oración es un bálsamo y una vía para todas esas cosas.
Prayer is the conduit for all of that.
Y dice al final, y no nos metas en tentación, mas líbranos del mal.
And he follows that, and do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
Algunos dicen que aquí hay una mala traducción del original griego.
Some people might say that there's an incorrect translation from the original Greek here.
Porque el que lee literalmente esto,
because the one who reads this literally,
por lo menos en español,
at least in Spanish,
parece que es Dios el que nos está metiendo en una tentación.
It might sound as if God might lead you to temptation at
times. No nos metas en tentación.
And do not lead us into temptation.
Pero eso no es correcto.
But that's not proper.
Porque la Biblia nos enseña que Dios no tienta a nadie ni él puede ser tentado por el mal.
Because Scripture makes clear that he does not tempt anyone and he cannot be tempted by anyone.
Porque Pablo nos dice,
because Paul even teaches us,
que no nos ha sobrevenido ninguna tentación que no sea humana.
And no temptation has overtaken you except such as is common to man.
Así que la idea de este texto,
so the idea of this
es la de clamar a Dios,
is that of exclaiming to
para
God,
que Dios nos libre del lazo del tentador.
So he may free us from the rope.
Es como decir, Señor, guarda mis pasos.
In other words, God protect, watch my every step.
Para no caer en tentación.
So that I may not fall into temptation.
La idea es pedir protección divina.
It's to ask for divine protection.
Y la oración es para eso también.
And prayers for that as well.
Saben. La gran realidad es que a algunos les preocupa pecar.
The sad truth is that a lot of people are worried about sinning.
Pero créeme que antes de pecar,
but believe you me that before you sin,
eres tentado.
You've been tempted.
El pecado no llega así de una vez.
Sin doesn't just manifest itself.
Primero llega la tentación.
First temptation comes.
La idea en la cabecita.
The thought.
Y empezamos a darle comidita a esa idea.
And we start feeding it.
Comenzamos a alimentarla.
And we start helping it grow.
Santiago describe este proceso como un embarazo, una gestación.
James describes this process as a pregnancy, a gestation.
Y dice que cuando esto sucede llega a dar luz al pecado.
He says that basically sin is birthed.
Y cuando el pecado es consumado da a luz, muerte.
And from there, when it's full grown, it brings forth death.
Así que es importante pedirle a Dios.
So it's important, critical. To
que nos guarde del lazo del tentador.
To keep us from the evil one.
Así que quiero recordarte al final algunas cosas.
I want to remind you a few things to close.
Y quizás empiezas a orar de otra manera.
And perhaps you might start praying differently.
Para que tengas una oración más efectiva.
To have effective prayer.
No actúes en la oración.
Do not act when you're praying.
Busca intimidad con Dios.
Seek out intimacy with God.
Privacidad.
Privacy.
No por gusto.
Not for fun.
Jesús dijo, entra en tu aposento y cierra la puerta.
Jesus said, enter into your room and shut the door.
Eso no quiere decir que no podemos orar en público.
Doesn't mean that we can't pray in public.
En la iglesia se ora en público.
In church we pray in public at times.
Pero en tu vida personal.
But in your personal life.
Busca privacidad con Dios.
Seek out that privacy with God.
No uses vana repetición.
Do not use vain repetitions.
Recuerda que Dios sabe lo que tú necesitas.
Remember that God knows what you need.
Acuérdate que Él está en el cielo y tú
remember,
en la tierra.
He's in heaven and you're here on earth.
Santifícalo en tu corazón.
Sanctify Him in your heart.
Recuerda que eres parte de su reino.
Remember that you're part of his kingdom.
Y que él es el rey.
And that he is the king.
Aprende a vivir en su voluntad.
Learn to live in his will.
Depende de su provisión cada día.
Depend on his provision daily.
Procura estar a cuentas con Dios siempre.
Make sure you're squared up with God always.
Procura estar a cuentas con tu prójimo.
And with your neighbors, your brothers.
Pídele a Dios que guarde tu vida.
Ask God to protect your life.
Y por último, no olvides.
And lastly, do not forget.
Lo que cierra esta oración.
What closes this prayer.
Él es el rey de la gloria por todos los siglos.
He's the king of the glory forever.
Jesús terminó diciendo, porque tuyo es el reino y la gloria por todos los siglos.
He closes it by saying, for yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Y yo creo que si mantenemos estos aspectos en nuestra mente,
and I think that if we maintain these principles in our minds,
aprenderemos a orar en otro sentido.
We're going to learn to pray in a different way.
Aprenderemos a ser más efectivos en la oración.
To have more effective prayer.
Y no tendremos una oración ritual en nuestra vida.
And we're not going to have a ritualistic prayer.
Señor, gracias porque hoy me desperté y me diste un nuevo día.
Lord, thank you because I awoke today and I got a new day.
Bendíceme y cuídame, amén.
Bless me and thank you, amen.
Eso es ritual.
That's ritual.
Aprende a ser tú delante de Dios.
Learn to be yourself in the sight of God.
Si hay algo que a mí me seduce de Dios,
if there's something that just attracts me to God,
es que Dios sabe quién soy yo.
Is that he knows who I am.
Sabe cómo yo hablo.
He knows how I talk.
Sabe cómo yo pienso.
He knows my thoughts.
Sabe lo que hay dentro de mí.
He knows what's in my heart.
¿Para qué actuar?
Why act?
¿Para qué vana palabrería?
Why the fancy words?
Habla con Dios de una manera sencilla.
Talk with God simply.
Él sabe quién eres tú.
He knows who you are.
Y tu oración será efectiva.
And your prayer shall be effective.
Vamos a orar.
Let's pray.
Padre, te damos gracias, Señor, por esta palabra.
Father, we thank you, Lord, for this word.
Gracias por tu enseñanza sobre la oración.
Thank you for your teachings on prayer.
Líbranos de la actuación.
Free us from being hypocrites.
De la repetición vana, hueca.
Vain, hollow repetitions.
Ayúdanos a hablar contigo de una manera sencilla.
Help us speak with you in a simple manner.
Sabiendo que tú lo sabes todo.
Knowing that you know everything.
¿Quiénes somos nosotros?
Who we are.
¿Qué hacemos?
What we do.
¿Qué pensamos?
What we think.
¿Qué necesitamos?
What we need.
Sencillamente, ayúdanos a hablar contigo.
Simply help us speak with you.
Ayúdanos a entender tu voluntad.
Help us understand your will.
A vivir bajo ella.
To live under it.
A saber que somos ciudadanos del reino.
And understand that we're citizens of the kingdom.
Y que tú eres ese rey maravilloso.
And that you're that marvelous king.
Señor, que podamos estar a cuenta contigo.
May we always be accountable with you, Father.
Porque la palabra dice que el pecado hace estorbo a nuestras oraciones.
Because sin, as scripture says, it's a stumbling block to our prayer.
Bendícenos.
Bless us.
Y ayúdanos a ser sencillos hijos tuyos.
And help us be simple.
Queremos vivir el poder de la oración en nuestras vidas.
We want to live the power of prayer in our lives.
Te lo pedimos en el nombre de Jesús.
We ask this in the name of Jesus.
Amen. 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 Thank you, guys.
Bueno, gracias.